Hi, I'm Greg, and I've initiated a petition to the New Zealand Parliament to amend Section 5 of the Bill of Rights 1990 to ensure there are no justified limits on the rights and freedoms described under the heading Life and Security of the Person. What are rights and freedoms if they can be removed because someone sneezed from a flu-like illness? This petition's object is to make absolute the rights and freedoms in Sections 8, 9, 10, and 11. And these are 8, the right not to be deprived of one's life. 9, the right not to be subjected to torture or cruel treatment. 10, the right not to be subjected to medical or scientific experiment. And 11, the right to refuse to undergo medical treatment. There is no justified reason to take a person's life or torture them, medicate or experiment on them against their will. Surely these are values most New Zealanders hold. No one ought accept medical treatment interventions they oppose. What's being done is criminal. New Zealanders are blackmailed to accept harm and injury. The amendment or fix I propose creates a new section 5A in the Bill of Rights, which is headed Unjustified Limitations and states, none of sections 4, 5, 6 provide any justified limits on rights and freedoms contained in sections 8, 9, 10 and 11. That's it. A simple declaration of our absolute right to bodily sovereignty. Unfortunately, it relies on politicians to reverse the carnage. However, some MPs might act to support this principle in a conscience vote where we the people make them do the people's will. Real science is becoming increasingly alarmed with the effects that are caused by COVID mRNA jabs. In the November 8 Journal of Cardiology, an abstract provided a warning by Stephen Gundry, who says, "We conclude that the mRNA vax dramatically increase inflammation. They may account for the observations of increased thrombosis, cardiomyopathy, and other vascular events following vaccination. Who wants themselves or their children repeatedly injected with mRNA toxins that mess up one's blood vessels and vital organs just to keep a vax passport up to date? The jabs neither stop infection nor transmission. The mantra safe and effective is a big lie. The reality is the vaccine passport will be a human data passport and necessary component for the New Zealand version of the Global Social Credit Scheme, implemented incrementally as opportunity presents to the Global Health Syndicate or the cabal running this COVID shit show." There's linked explanations of the petition and implications of vax passports in the description below. We are the ones who must stop this crime. We cannot leave this ugly mess for our children to fix. Humankind only happens when humanity is free to care. Please sign and share the petition. Our values are peace, love, freedom, and human rights. Thank you for watching.